I was yesterday saying that I will do a talk about the throat, then I changed it because it was not complete and not focused well as I wanted. Meaning by that it is quite a huge question, and it is another of those high fundamentals into the voice. Italian bel canto techniques solve the question of the throat by copertura concept and a little more ancient in its style by the sustain concept. Why? Because they are related. So when we say that the throat in the sense of do we have to use it, when it is useful to use it, when does it become something not that nice into the sound, when it becomes something dangerous into the vocal folds. Again, we can solve it just by putting the sustain, covering a lot of sound, and we have all the elasticity we need. We cover, we put dark, we get up, we have all our passages of register, and all it's all right, it's balanced, it's correct, but we lose some freedom into the capacity of changing the colors, of shaping the vowels, of putting some pressures. That the pressure under the vocal folds is not always a bad thing. First of all, we need a pressure under the vocal folds to make properly work the vocal folds. So there also, it is tricky just because sometimes we don't think that it's a continuum. Continuum meaning that there is not just the covered sound correct and the vocal folds relaxed, and on the opposition, just the vocal folds strained but the pressure and the throat sound. It is a continuum. It is a continuum in which the sustain and the covering, they work together in this shaping the sounds. And in this shaping the sounds, as always, we have to think that we have a segment that is good enough for who? For your specifics. So the first thing is to understand how to put those boundaries. And to know when you start singing, or you're not very good, or you had a fixed larynx, or you have a bad sustain, this segment will be shorter and closer. That is why you can't do what other people do, because you have to start training where you are. So first thing is that you have, you or your trainer, or your vocal coach, or yourself if you're a singer, or yourself on your students if you're a coach, or a voice teacher, call yourself as you want, you have to understand if there is in your pupil or in yourself these segments. People I work with, sometimes they don't have it. And sometimes they don't have even the medium voice. And especially, and very often is a problem of this segment is not present anymore clearly. So the first thing is, or you do the exercises to start having a little of this, or you just look where you have this segment. In this segment, what you do there and there will be a little dangerous. Can be nice for some things when you're really trained, when you're really a good singer, when you have all the segments you need, and then you can go a little on the side sometimes, always sometimes, and control that your segment when you do that don't get shorter. The sense that you're working well is that the segment or is stable, and it is stable for your repertoire, or it's getting improving till where it is correct for your repertoire. Every time you work badly with vocal folds and with vocal tract and with all the relations, you have all this segment getting shorter, or the sound losing some specific overtones that are the overtones of sustain well working with your vocal folds. So we have this segment. In this segment, what happens? We can be down notes, low notes. We start from here. The larynx is down, and then we go up into the extension till the end. And the sustain and our larynx will come accordingly, getting up and little turning accordingly to all the extension. And this is what the Italian bel canto technique preaches. Cetrix copertura is the one of Pavarotti, is the safest copertura you can have. At the same time, it is in my taste can be very good for some kind of styles, some people, not very good if you want not a little more of life and of pressure and of not only aggressivity but a kind of energy, a specific kind of energy of a higher level into the voice. There are some people who have this kind of energy. You can think about Chaka Khan, for example, or Aretha Franklin. They have all the time this kind of energy, and we have this will not have the coopertura of set rigs because it will not become a sound. And it is safe, of course it is safe. You see those two, it is totally safe. And it is possible to have something of that kind in you. How? When you cover less than how set rigs and Pavarotti says, you will feel a little more the sustain pushing under your vocal folds. In that way, you will feel a little more your throat. And the less you're covering and the more you get with the sustain without covering, you have two options not to strain the vocal folds. The first is that you let your larynx coming up and turning with your sustain, and this is what a certain style quite ancient of Italian bel canto technique, and you find also in Lily Lemon, Matilde Marchesi, you find it quite pure. She didn't want any kind of duck into the voice, so she wants the pure A, that is the purest A you can have, just with the sustain and with the enough copertura, not to have a fake sound. She felt it was a fake sound, and she put things quite to an extreme. And this is a concept of leggerezza. So it will not get into the throat, you will not feel the throat sound, you will feel that the sound becomes more leggero. That is not inconsistent, it's just you have the component of the sustain with enough copertura, but not the weight and not the how can I say, the pronunciation and the deep of the sound making the sound, but just sustain and enough copertura for all the extension. This is one possibility. The other possibility, it is that you put the sustain and you don't follow in the same measure with the larynx. This will make what? That you can do a little segment you follow, then you stop, and this will make the sound go a little behind and getting into the throat. Getting into the throat meaning that you will feel that the pressure is going to augment. You will not perceive into the vocal folds, because if you do correctly, you will not perceive immediately there. Some can perceive there, some others they will not, because first of all, you will not be able to do that too much. Too much is when you perceive too much, and outside you will have a too stiff sound. But you can do a bit. Well, you'll find that do that in the belting, for example. The belting is just that. You come correct till a certain point, and for some notes you just use the pressure and remain into the position without making really a higher position. Never do that if you're too young. Never do that if you don't have a very strong instrument, very well developed, and it can sustain this kind of pressure. This is the segment in which you must all the time move. It's very personal. If you had a bad cold, if you had an hypotonical vocal folds, if you had a deficit abductor, you will not be able to do that immediately. You will be able to do that when your vocal folds will be shaped correctly. And how much you can do that, it will be the sound to tell yourself. The throat sound being that you are doing too much. Simply.